Hi guys. So I stumbled upon a question on Reddit yesterday, and since I had the same problem just a few months ago, I thought I'd make a tutorial. Me, the expert. No, just I want to show you how I created a street map or a street index, whatever you want to call it. So like you have a grid on a map and you want to know which grid column or row the streets is in. And I have the OSM road network of Iceland, and I already prepared an A3 format layout and a map frame which contains the background map and the road network, and I already zoomed into one part that I deemed fitting. So what you want to do is preferably make a clip of your displayed maps, and there are few ways to achieve that, but I like to just activate the map frame and then select everything that I can see and export that. So when you export the features, it will just export the selected features. And I could also could have done the next clip, which would have been smarter, but I didn't think of that. So you can see it's just this part of the street network now. The next step I did, because the OSM data contains line segments of the whole road, so it's not just one line for one road, but it's multiple light features for the whole road, I dissolve it. with the name of the streets. And if you need more than just the names of the streets, other attributes and so on, you could also use them as statistic fields. I don't know. Like ref, and then you could choose your statistic type if you need all of them, all of the ref attributes that are contained in the line segments. You could use concatenate or unique, whatever you need, but I don't need that, I just want the names. Then I run and let's open the attribute table. As you can see here, this was, I can't speak Icelandic, so I don't know how to pronounce it. This route, for example, is in the table 4 times at least. And if you open the dissolved network, you can see that it just appears once. Also, we don't need streets that don't have a name, because how would you know which name is displayed or is meant? So I will clip them out. I don't know. Reduce them with the definition query, where the name is not equal empty, so it will just display the streets that have a name. If you open it again, you can see that the empty one is gone. Now I will label it so you can see the names. Then the next thing I like to do, because it's easier to display it properly in ArcGIS Pro, you could also use Excel if you did all the other steps, and then use Excel to sort streets accordingly, or sort the grid cell names, whatever. But it's easier this way if you do it in just one program. So you take the saw tool, you use your dissolved road net, and then you sort by name ascending, so it starts with A and goes all the way to Z. And you can see it's ABC and so on. Then you can display the grids with the ABC and the 1, 2, 3 by adding a grid to the map frame and choosing one of those. I'll just take this one. Then you can set your rows and columns, I think. I guess I can make a few more. 6 and 7 is okay. Then you have the names, or like the letters and the numbers around the map frame. And this grid is not... you can't join this spatially with the underlying data, because this is a layout element and it's not inside the map, so to speak. So you need to create a grid inside the map, and what I did is create a fishnet. Database default, I already tried it. And then for the template extent, you can choose the currently visible extent, and it will set all the coordinates for you, and you will assure you're sure to just have the this area for the grid. And then you can choose either the cell size, width and height, but you need to do math for that and I don't like it. But we know that we have 6 rows and 7 columns, so you can just 6 rows, 7 columns, put this in there and change the output to polygon, because you want to have squares and not just the lines. Then you run it. And then I forgot, you can unclick this one, you don't need it. But I forgot. And then you have your fishnet, and if you zoom in, you can see that the lines are overlapping, so it's exactly the size of the reference grid. The next thing you need to do, I like to just have it black, is you want to get the names into the grid, because if you look at this now, it's just the length and the area, and you can't do shit with that. And what I did, I bet there are easier ways and faster ways, but if you know it, let me know. I have no idea. What I did was make the layer editable. English is not my first language. And under modify, I already have it open here, you have the sequential numbering, and you can choose how you... oh. What's missing? Why is this not working? It was working before. Numbering? Oh, of course. You need a column for the names to go on. So you add a column to your fishnet grid, name or whatever you want to call it, and make it text, because it will contain the letters and the numbers. Save. And now it should be... yes, thank god. You already have the name field chosen, And in the format, you can look it up in the help, the, the hashtag sign is the wildcard for numbers, and you can also wildcard the letters, I think, but I'm not sure. But I want the same letter in one column, but numbers to go up from 1 to 6. So my start value will be 1, and my increment will be 1. And as soon as you click this button, you get a cross, and you can just click once and go all the way down and double click to finish. And then you see the whole column is selected. And if you open the attribute table, you see that every 6th, 7th row is selected, and they all have the A and sequential numbers. So you will just do this for all the columns. It's easier if you don't have as many columns or rows. Let's now click on the B and make sure you always set start value to 1, else you end up with 7 to, I don't know, 8, 9, whatever. C, D.
All prayers are heard high up in the throne.
E. Let's learn the alphabet. Alright, so you clear the selection, then we open the attribute table again, and as you can see now, you have all the numbers and the letters. If you select this, you can see that it's just the first row that ends with 1, and ABC, and so on. Now clear the selection. Always remember to clear the selection if you want to work with the whole data set, because I learned it the hard way. If you have stuff selected and you use geoprocessing tools, it's a pain in the ass to do it again because you just use the selected ones. Always save in between. ArcGIS is prone to just close. And then you will also sort the fishnet names. Let's sort. So the when you display the data later on in the text field below the map, you have the street name and then the cell name in alphabetical order. So it starts with 1, goes all the way to G. If it's if the street is that long. If you don't do this step, the street, also the grid, the cell names, whatever, will be random. I mean, not random, it will go through this list and just put it in there. Just sort it, it's easier. So you have this layer and this layer. So nicely sorted. And the last thing you need to do is a spatial join the streets with the grid. So it will look at the street and join all the grids it goes through. You do this by join and relate as a spatial join with the sorted fishnet intersect, because you want every piece of street that just nicks the little bits of the grid. And the fishnet grids attributes, I just need the name. And take care to use join so you get all the grid names, the cell names, and not just one. And for the limiter, I choose this. Then you click OK. And if you open it again, you can see here you have the grids. And then it's just saving this feature layer. We go back to the layout. I already inserted a text field. If you go to insert dynamic text, there's a thing called value. And you can choose the layer and the stuff you want to have displayed from it. So we choose the index layer, custom query we don't need. We want all the rows. And I want to have the name of the street displayed, as well as the names of the cells and delimiter, so it's all in a new row. This. And then you click somewhere and then you, you just use this to put it in your text field. You could also type this by hand. If I paste it, you will see it's not that easy, and I can't remember, it's just easier this way. And as you can see, the streets are in there with the grid names. You could also use, I don't know if this was here. Somewhere is, you have the ability to show a table frame with the data. But just for showiness sake, I think this applies. Why is this there? Yes. And that's it. You can display the names again. And then you have your streets, and you can look it up. These are not all the streets, so just made the one too big, but yeah, that's it. I hope that helped. Maybe not. Maybe it did. Who knows? Have a nice day.